Hello students, in this lesson, let us start doing the problems on airport engineering. So the first problem is regarding the calculation of actual length of the runway. So in the previous two lectures, we have seen how to calculate the actual length of the runways, that is based on the formulas, and also we have seen the corrections for the actual length of runway, right? So those things we will be implementing in the problems which are coming ahead. So the first question says, calculate the actual length of the runway from the following data. So the airport elevation is given as reference level 100. Airport reference temperature is 28 degrees centigrade. Basic runway length is 600 meters. Highest point along the length is RL 98.2, and the lowest point along the length is RL 95.2. So basically we have to do three corrections to get the actual length from the basic length of the runway, right? The first correction is correction for elevation, right? So what is the standard? We have to increase the basic length at the rate of 7% per 300 meter elevation above the mean sea level. So this is the standard correction for your elevation, right? So let's complete the calculation. So this will be equal to what? 7% means what? 7/100 of the airport elevation. So what is the airport elevation given to you? 100. So this should be the airport elevation divided by the 300 meters, whatever we have. So this value will go on changing for each and every problem. So this, if on calculation, will give us 14 meters. So the length of runway after correction for elevation will become how much? 7/100 the basic length of runway, which is your 600 meters, plus the correction, which is the 14 meters. So 614 meters. Then after that, we need to do the correction for temperature. So basically all three corrections we need to do in all the problems given to us for the calculation of your actual length. Okay, now how do you do correction for temperature? What is standard? So we know that the standard atmospheric temperature at your mean sea level is equal to 15 degree. So even this is not given, we have to remember this, right? Now taking the temperature gradient as equal to 6.5 degree centigrade per 1000 meter raise in elevation. So that is the standard, right? So what is it? Temperature gradient equal to 6.5 degree centigrade per 100 meter raise in elevation. So based on this, what will be the standard temperature at the airport? This will nothing but be the temperature at RL 100, because the airport elevation is 100, right? So this will be equal to 15, that is your standard atmospheric temperature at mean sea level, minus your 6.5 degree centigrade for every 1000 meter. But how much is given to us? 1000 meter elevation this is, but the elevation given to us is how much? 100, right? So this is the value that will change. The rest of the things will remain same, right? So how much will you get? This equal to 14.35 degree centigrade. So what will be the difference now? Difference between the airport reference temperature and standard atmospheric temperature. So airport reference temperature is given to us, which is how much? 28 degrees centigrade minus the standard temperature which we have calculated just now. So this will give us equal to 13.65 degree centigrade. So correction should be applied. The correction for temperature should be applied at a rate of, this is again standard, so 1 degree for every 1% for every 1 degree, right? So based on this, what will be the temperature correction? So this will be equal to 1% means 1 by 100. We have to take now, already elevation correction is happened, no? So we have to take this value for every 614 meters into the difference in the temperature, that is 13.65. So this will come somewhere around 38.15. So we can take it as, sorry, 83.15. So we can take it as 84 meters. So what will be the length of runway? So the length of runway after elevation and temperature correction is equal to how much? 614 plus the 84 what we have got. So this will be equal to 698 meters. So the next is what? The correction for gradient. So what is the standard correction for gradient? First of all, calculate the effective gradient. What is the formula for effective gradient? The highest point along the length, RL, right, minus the lowest point along the length, RL, whole divided by the basic length of the runway. That is nothing but your 600. So this will give you a value of 3 by 600 or you can call it as 0.5%. So now applying the correction for effective gradient is what? At a rate of 20 degree for each 1% effective gradient. So how do you do it? So gradient correction will be equal to, so 20% is nothing but 20 by 100 of this length after the correction of elevation and temperature. So that 698 into this 0.5%, that's nothing but 0.5 by 1. Okay, so this will give you a value of 69.8, which is equal to somewhere around 70 meters. So therefore your actual length of runway will be how much? Add all three of them, that is 698, which is after two correction, plus this 70 will give you 768 meters. Now after all this, so this is the required answer, which is nothing but the actual length of the runway, but we have to check it is within, according to ICAO standard, we know that it should not be more than 35%. So we will have to calculate. So what is the total correction for elevation plus temperature? So for elevation it is 14, for temperature it is 84, which is equal to 98 meters, right? Now this percentage increase will be how much? 98 by the total is how much? 600. We have to convert it into percentage. So this will give you a value of 16.33%, which is less than your 35%. Answer or the corrected length we have got is the final one. If it exceeds, we have to change. Okay. So hope the solution is clear to you now. Thank you.